Loop components are becoming very popular. You know why? Because they can be added anywhere. Right now, at least, they can be added in email, chat, meetings, Word, and its own dedicated workspace. In fact, we have videos for all of them. But one thing I have not covered fully, that's what I'll do today. So we have not covered the individual component from loop components. There are many of them, but broadly, few categories. Once you get the idea, you will be able to use them more effectively. At this point of time, there are 9 components, and the list is likely to grow. And even third-party components like Jira or Trello have also been introduced. Now, whenever you write something, it can have formatting. So formatting has color and heading styles. That's not really a component, it's more of an embellishment kind of thing. Whenever you type something, you have to decide, is it regular text or is it heading 1, 2, 3? And for each one of them, there are colors you can choose from. Colors also come in 2 types, just the color or background plus foreground color. Nice, attractive combinations. Anything which is put as loop components can be reordered within the component and across the component. Just drag drop. If you want to attract attention, there is a quote and a call out as well. The callout has a pin by default, but you can change that. Any emoticon can be added. Oh, by the way, you know, independent of loop components, you can add emoticons anywhere in Windows. The shortcut is Windows and dot or period key. Then there are 4 which are related to communication. What does that mean? Person. In many places, we want to say this task will be done by this person. So you need to have a text box where you put @ and it'll find people's names. All that happens with person. You can put it as an individual part of a paragraph, or many tables already have it, which we'll see later. Emoji and image are just for illustration. You can add them from anywhere. And the last one is interesting, label. Label is basically a choice. There are 2 labels which are given already, but you can create more. We'll see that as we go along. As the page gets more and more components, it's going to get more and more crowded and lengthy, and you will lose track of what happens. So you need a table of contents. So the first component you should always put is table of contents. Even if it is empty right now, that's okay. Now, as you add more components, table of contents is automatically refreshed. Even in Word, it doesn't happen like that. You have to go and refresh it manually. The only confusing part I found with table of contents is it does show me hyperlinks, but they don't behave like hyperlinks. At least in my case, I don't know why. I click, nothing happens. Control click, nothing happens. Double click works. Maybe that's by design, or maybe it's a bug, I don't know. But double click, table of contents. Simplest one of them is paragraph. Now you'll say, why would I want a single paragraph to be a component? We always have paragraphs in any document, right? And why would I collaborate only on a paragraph? That's a very good question. And think a little, your vision statement, a tagline for your product, or some copy which is going in an ad. Those are single paragraphs or even one sentence sometimes, where people spend months finalizing it. So don't say there is no need. There are specific places where each of these components can be the heaviest part of collaboration. And anyway, we are not competing with Word. This is just a different way of working. By all means, for formal documents, you continue to use Word. For ad hoc collaboration, use this or chat. The next one is lists. You can just have a simple list, bulleted list, or a number list. A variation of the list is checklist, because it's a list, but I want to say this is done, this is not done. Very interesting. Checklists are very useful. In fact, wherever there is standardization in any industry, like say aviation or healthcare, checklists are the mainstay of work. OneNote also has amazing checklist option. This is another alternative you have for collaboration. The next more complex data structure we have is tables, of course. You create a table, add rows and columns, rearrange them, sort them, expand it, collapse it, all kinds of things you can do. Now, the interesting part about tables is not just add rows and columns, that you can do in Word as well, much more sophisticated actually. The difference here is, here you can have data type. So it's somewhere simplified version of Excel and lists. I have created this table, and each column actually shows you the data type. And that makes it really powerful, because one is text, one is number. In fact, when you put a number, it actually automatically gives you summary below. Sum, count, or average, you choose. Then you saw person earlier, voting. So person becomes a column. In that column, when you click, automatically email IDs come, search for it, put the email ID of person. Another very useful thing. So bottom line, rich table for quick data capture collaboratively, there is no faster way of doing. Am I saying this is replacing Excel? No. Is it replacing lists? No. In fact, you should see the list video because that will reduce misuse of Excel. But this is for simple collaboration with few people quickly without getting into any complexity. So tables are flexible, but Microsoft also created some reusable tables with predefined format. So the first one is called Progress Tracker. So these are the columns it gives, and you can add more columns if you like. Similarly, we have a voting table. So I have an idea, I have pros and cons, and people will just say I liked it or not. So that voting column is nice. People just click on it and you get a counter there saying, oh, so many people said good for this. It's not a yes, no, it's a counter. But the most important loop component, in my opinion, is tasks, loop tasks. Why is it so important? Not because it's just a loop component, because it integrates with other things like to-do and planner. So when I create a loop task list, I can see it in planner as well. And I can customize it there as well as here, and they will sync. Very good. The other part is to do. Imagine, we have seen this in meetings as well. The same thing is likely to happen in loop workspaces. I have created multiple workspaces. Each workspace is for a project. And in each project, I have a task list, maybe one or more task list. And some of those tasks are for me. Now, how am I going to see that? Even in loop, there is no way to consolidate. That's where I go to my to do app. And I get to see all my tasks across all loop components and planner in one place assigned to me. So that integration makes this a very attractive proposition. I put a task list literally wherever I feel like, in a meeting, in loop workspace, in Word, in email, or in Teams chat. And irrespective of that, I get a combined consolidated list of my work. So try it out if you have not done it. In fact, watch the meetings video as well. And now you will get a much better idea of which loop component to use when, how, and why. And finally, if you are a developer, there is a code snippet as well. It supports 14 languages as of now, one of which is plain text, I think. And it does support syntax coloring and line numbering. If you want to collaborate on code, yes, you can do that. Did you know that there is a code snippet available in Teams chat as well, and that supports many more languages. Another interesting component is label. By default, it gives you two types of labels, but you can create your own. It's basically a list of choices, and it automatically gives them colors actually. Now, if you don't like the color it has given, yes, you can change the color as well. So labels are basically choices. So that completes the coverage of current state of loop components. Yes, there is Jira and Trello as well, and more third-party components are likely to come in future. But understanding individual loop components will give you a better collaborative experience wherever you use those components. So that's it for now. Thank you.